Who gives this woman to be wedded to this man?
Her mother and I.
You may present the bride. You may be seated. We are assembled here on this most sacred occasion in the sight of God and all these that are sitting present to join together this man and this woman into the holy and sacred relationship of marriage. This relationship should not be entered into or should be entered into with love and respect toward God's holy laws. It should not be treated as common or taken for granted, seeing that he ordained this holy, sacred relationship from the very beginning of the human family. And the Lord God said, "It is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helpmate for him." And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the rib which the Lord God had taken from man made he a woman and brought her unto the man. And Adam said, "This is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of the man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh." This estate of life is also portrayed in the New Testament between Christ and the church. Christ blessed the marriage of Cana when he turned the water into wine. Christ is looked upon as being the bridegroom and the church being the bride. This was explained by the Apostle Paul as he wrote the letter to the Ephesians. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, as we enter into this most sacred occasion, Lord, to join this brother and sister in marriage, we pray, Lord, that heaven's blessings would be upon them, and that, Lord, you would unite their hearts as well as their hands, Lord, as they stand here together in respect to one another. May you bless them and help them and guide them through life and give them a great marriage. We pray these things in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Now, charge the two of you, as you stand here, that you think seriously upon this moment and the vows that you are about to take. Blake Collwell, will you take this woman to be your lawful wedded wife, to live with her according to God's holy ordinance? Will you love, honor, comfort, and cherish her in health and in sickness, in prosperity and adversity, and forsaken all others? Keep yourself to her only as long as the both of you shall live.
I will.
Rachel Coward, will you take this man to be your lawful wedded husband, to live with him according to God's holy ordinance? Will you love, honor, comfort, and cherish him in health and in sickness, in prosperity and adversity, and forsaking all others, keep yourself to him only as long as you both shall live?
Repeat after me. I, Blake Collwell, take thee, Rachel Coward, to be my wedded wife,
to be my wedded wife,
to have and to hold,
to have and to hold,
from this time forward,
from this time forward,
for better, for worse,
for better, for worse,
for richer, for poorer,
for richer, for poorer,
in health and in sickness,
in health and in sickness,
to cherish and to love, until death do us part,
until death do us part,
according to God's holy ordinance,
according to God's holy ordinance.
And to this I pledge thee,
and to this I pledge thee,
my faith,
Rachel, repeat after me. I, Rachel Coward.
I, Rachel Coward.
Take thee, Blake Collwell.
Take thee, Blake Collwell.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this time forward.
From this time forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In health and in sickness. To cherish and to love.
To cherish and to love.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And to this I do pledge thee my faith.
And to this I do pledge thee my faith.
Down through the ages of time, the golden circle of the wedding ring has sealed the vows of marriage and symbolized the purity of endless love. The circle, which has no beginning and no ending, is a pledge of the true love which is eternal. Blake, what token and pledge do you offer that you will faithfully fulfill these vows? Wait a minute. Go ahead.
Rachel, do you accept this ring in token of the same covenant upon your part?
I do.
I place the ring upon her finger. With this, and repeat after me, Blake. With this ring I do thee wed.
With this ring I do thee wed.
And pledge to thee my love and loyalty.
And pledge to thee my love and loyalty.
Rachel, what token and pledge do you offer that you will faithfully fulfill these vows? This ring.
Blake, do you accept this in token of this same covenant upon your part?
I will.
Rachel, with this ring I do thee wed.
With this ring I do thee wed.
And pledge to thee my love and loyalty.
And pledge to thee my love and loyalty.
Inasmuch as Blake and Rachel have covenanted together in holy matrimony before God and these persons present, and have pledged their faith each to the other, and declared the same by the exchange of rings and joining of hands, I do now pronounce them to be husband and wife in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Those whom God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. Henceforth, as you go down life's pathway, let love be the cherished word in your conversation, in the conversation of your home and hearts. May heaven's constant benediction crown your union with everlasting joy and blessedness, and unite your hearts and lives by all the grace and true affection of a happy marriage that is dedicated unto Christ. You may kiss the bride. It gives me the honor and pleasure to present to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Blake and Rachel Collwell.
And I know I can love her more. perish and serve you, and will bring you glory today. I pray.
And enjoy some food, and they will be going shortly. So after they come and bid you out, then you can go on the fellowship hall. So let us pray over the food before you do. Heavenly Father, we thank you now for Blake and Rachel, and we pray your blessings upon them, Lord. We just thank you for your kindness to them and for the wedding of how that it has gone. And Lord, we just thank you for your everlasting love for all of us. Thank you for truth now. And we pray your blessings upon this food. In Jesus Christ's name, amen.